Gogo. I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarubyanisha@gmail.com. You can also visit my website www.tarubyanisha.com. And this is your monthly forecast for August 2015. Virgos, this is an extremely important month for you. I can't emphasize the extremely bit of it. And it's a month wherein that you'll find if you work towards getting what you want, your dreams will actually get realized. And there is, of course, a little bit of balancing act as well that you'll have to do. We have Saturn that is going direct. And this aspect you will see again only after 27 years. So take full advantage of it and make full good use of it. And Saturn is going direct in Scorpio, and this is happening in a part of your chart that has to do, it's a house of higher mind and it's a house of communication and travel. And over here, Saturn is, it's talking about things that are, especially when you are communicating with others. And Saturn is, you know, the energy is very heavy. It brings about a lot of responsibility. So conversation, promises, or even when you're dealing with others, which have no really meaning or purpose, it is something that you are going to be sort of be staying away from. I think there is a sense of seriousness and a sense of responsibility as far as speech is concerned. There is also the pattern in which you think, you know, what is it that and how it is that you think so far. So if you have a very confined way of thinking that has been so far, that you've not been maybe exploring, or you don't want to take the risk of really expanding your life and exploring your true potential, this is the time where with Saturn going direct, it's just going to sort of make you be more serious about your own thinking pattern. And that's the time where Saturn is going to be pushing you and asking you that what you think, is it the right way of thinking? Or maybe there is you need to be having more knowledge, you need to be having more information. It seems that you need to be doing more, you need to be learning more about a certain can be a certain situation which you're not completely aware about as to how to handle it. In certain cases, it can also be that it literally speaks about a higher education, that some of you will actually be applying for a higher degree or adding a skill set to yourself so that you're more equipped to be handling the current wider role that life is presenting you. And this is a time where also about day-to-day chores, you know, where things will, you'll find quite irritated by the mundaneness of life, because you're just more keen to have these serious conversations. You want to, you no longer want to brush things under the carpet, Virgos. You are going to be wanting some quite hard answers over here. Now, Jupiter is going to be entering your sign, and this is happening on the 11th of August, and this is happening for the first time in 12 years. And it's happening in your own sign. But the thing with Jupiter over here is that Jupiter is detriment, so be a little careful. And by detriment, I mean that when a planet is really not to its playing up to its ultimate potential that it can, you know, it just feels more restrained. So it's not a retrograde and it's not a bad position to be in, but it just sort of tempers the entire effect or potential of a planet, what it is capable of doing. So you just have to sort of manage with the expectations of what it is that you would want out of life. And since it's focusing on you, it's focusing on your dreams, your desires, and it's just that if there is a heightened sense of optimism, or there's a heightened sense of expectancy of what you want out of your life, your dreams, your desires, Jupiter over here is saying that, you know, it's great to be having that kind of a vision, or even that kind of looking at life very broadly, but you really need to be tempering it, you know. Don't sort of get too carried away with it, you know. It's you still need to be cautious about the implementation or even the reality of what it is that you really want in life and what it is that is really going to be happening. It's a great time, Virgos, for self-improvement. For those of you who have been wanting to make a lot of changes in your own life, and it's a time wherein that when you're dealing with public and you're wanting to, you know, with the way that you're presenting yourself at the world outside, it's just that your image is going to be quite expanded, and you're going to be in certain cases we looked at as a potential leader. Maybe there is a larger role, you will be looked upon as a sort of an expert in your own field, so that would mean that greater work responsibilities. Even at home you can find that while there is this, maybe for some of you it can be that you want that perfect home, you know, it's just that desire that you have. I think all of us have it, but you need to be, while you're optimistic and while Jupiter will sort of, you know, expand it to whatever best that it can, you need to be realistic about it and not get disappointed about how the situation is and to how the situation it is that you want it to get or change in the future. And it's a time wherein you would want to be creating quite a distinct impression on others. So it can be that you're participating in a lot of seminars, conferences, either you're representing your company or your company is also looking at you as this person whom they hold in high esteem. So it's a good time. During this time as well, try and not to, as far as work is concerned. So if you have been, you know, saying that, oh, I should have got that particular promotion or that particular role, it didn't happen, don't get disheartened, you know, it'll happen, but okay, so maybe it's not happening to that exact level that you wanted it. Now, Venus, the goddess of love, beauty, money and values, is going to be retrograde this entire month. And this is happening in a part of your chart that has to do with behind the scenes, and it speaks about spirituality, it speaks about compassion. And Venus over here is going to be making you reassess and rethink as to how it is that you're really in connect with yourself, and are you really, how much is it that you're really connected with spirituality, and are you really a compassionate person, are you really this kind person that you think you are, and then what is it that you're doing about it. And it's also that in certain cases they can be that there's a painful past that is not letting you go ahead and move ahead in life and maybe make that commitment that is there. And Venus over here, now during a retrograde Venus, you know, we all astrologers say it's not a great time to be investing, it's not a great time to be buying big ticket items, it's not a great time to be doing any major, because it's also rules beauty, so any aesthetic change in yourself, buying of clothes, cosmetic corrections and so on and so forth, you need to be really be staying away till the time the retrograde gets over. It's a time wherein that there could just be a sense of urgency of wanting to make a certain or take a certain decision, but it's best if you reevaluate that decision and see as to, you know, just wait it out a little bit, you know, try not to sort of rush into making a decision over there. It's just that there may not be enough clarity or you may not have enough facts around you, Virgos. So quite a month for you, Virgos. It's been a pleasure speaking with you. I'll see you again next month, and thank you so much for watching.